Good morning and welcome to Boulder Valley Unitarian Universalist Fellowship. I'm Lisa, I'm the intern minister here, and I'm joined today by Service Associate TC. Carmen Sandem and Clara Kelly are providing our music, and our tech ushers, Mary Stackpole and Deborah Mensch. They help things run really smoothly. Most of all, are you the people that are here in this fellowship? Gather here. You're wonderful, and you are the reason that we do all of this and any of it. As I say the welcome words today, I invite you to shift into gallery mode, if you haven't already done so, and scroll through the screens so you can experience the lovely diversity of this congregation, because without it and without you, there would be no us. You are all welcome here today. In all the beauty of languages, cultures, skin tones, shapes, and sizes that come together in your uniqueness, you are welcome here. In all the ways you experience and express gender, you are welcome here. In the beauty that is who you love and how you love, you are welcome here. In all the ways you make your living and places you are from, you are welcome here. Christian, pagan, humanist, Jew, Buddhist, mystic, Muslim, Unitarian, Universalist, questioning, with all the traditions that inform your spiritual life, you are welcome here today. No matter how long you are away, nor how soon you will return, you are welcome here. Whether you come with laughter in your heart or tears, you are welcome here. You are invited to join with us with an open mind, a loving heart, and willing hands. We welcome you here today. As usual, we have some announcements this morning, and I'll ask Tad to go first. Tad's here.
Am I unmuted now? Good morning, Boulder Valley. I'm Tad Corriath, your director of music. I'm here to warmly invite you to a special evening of entertainment that we have planned for you. Coming up on Saturday, February 6th, at 6:30, right here on this Sunday Services Zoom room, we'll be hosting the Fellowship Fun Night. Emily and I are gonna perform a few songs. We'll have some singing along, as well as some other random silliness peppered throughout the evening, but the main attraction is going to be our beloved fellowship guest musician, the fabulous jazz pianist and composer, Carmen Sandem, who will offer us a little mini concert live. And as Lisa mentioned, Carmen is here. I'm not sure if she's here. She said she might have to be attending her kids this morning. But she's provided almost all of our music for service this morning. So. If you're unfamiliar with her, today will be a great opportunity, a little teaser for what you'd be in store for on Saturday. She accompanied all the hymns. The opening piece of music that we're going to hear is her own composition. And I especially would invite you to pay attention to the offertory piano music. That's her improvisation and arrangement on How Can I Keep From Singing. It's really quite interesting and quite beautiful and takes your ear in unexpected directions. So it's truly lovely. And I'm sure there'll be much more just like that on Saturday, 6:30 p.m. Fellowship Fun Night right here in this Zoom room. See you there.
Well, We have, after the service, we do have coffee and connection with the elected leaders. And so you're invited into that breakout room. And we also will have a breakout room where TC and I will be if you'd like to have any conversations about the service or anything else. And I have, we have one more very important bit of information, which Reverend Lydia would like to speak about.
Good morning, beloveds. I am joining you from BVUUF Studio One, although today is Lisa's day. I'm delighted to be here while Lisa leads the service. So we have had a whirlwind of a month. I think so many of us were ready for 2020 to be over, and then 2021 has been has given us just as much challenge, I think, between our national events and also here in our congregation with our inclusion and anti-racism work. We experienced a lot of pivots. I know you may have been kind of dizzy by the number of times we said, nope, we're doing this, now we're doing this. There have been twists and turns, disappointments, and even hurts along the way during this process. So I really wished it were easier, but I also know and recognize that this is part of the challenge of doing anti-racism work and work in inclusion, excuse me. So for my own part, I realized that I started the conversation about consultancy with our board, which is currently all white, and I did not include BIPOC folks in that initial conversation before the decision was made. So therefore, my big learning was I still kept white decision-making central. And that's what we're trying to shift and pull apart if we really want to be inclusive. We want to be including the people who are most impacted or for whom the work is central. So that decision, that initial decision, I really believe had impact all the way through this bumpy process we've had this month. But I do need you to know that I remain committed to this process over the long haul. Nothing about anti-racism work is done in a workshop or two. And I also know that our board and the rest of our leadership is also very, very committed to this. So in some ways, I'm just saying, hang on for the ride. It's likely to still be bumpy, and I know we can do this. So in the meantime, we are pushing the pause button while the planning team regroups. Currently, that planning team is Jim Highsmith and Scott Yeomans from the board, Chrissy Tano from the newly formed JEDI Equity and Inclusion Group, which is currently part of Lifespan Faith Formation, but probably won't stay in that spot, our intern minister, Lisa Moore, and me. So feel free to contact any of us along the way, and we will keep you informed as to what's happening. I also just want to say how impressed I am that so many of you signed up and are wanting to do this work. And I think we are in a moment in this congregation that is mirrors the moment we're in the nation. And so I remain confident that we can make the changes we want to make to become more inclusive, more anti-racist, and dismantle the practices we have that keep white supremacy culture in place in this congregation. So hang with us. You know, it's beautiful, deep, rich, and sometimes difficult work. So thank you.
If you're new here, we are glad you found us. And we hope that in this virtual community, you can experience the warmth and love of this congregation. Each Sunday is a little different here, and today might be exceptionally so. That's my plan. So come back, please, a few times to really get to know us. If you want to get better connected, please see the chat window for the link to our first time visitors page, or email your information to our office manager, Carol at officemanager@bvuuf.org. Her email address will be in the chat window as well. And please check out the Fellowship Calendar and Connections Weekly for all the opportunities we have to stay connected. And finally, for any of you newbies who would like to introduce yourself in the chat, please do. We love to know who is among us. As I'd mentioned before, We have conversations and coffee hours after the service, so you are all welcome to join one of those when we're done. I'm going to start our chalice lighting. So if you have a chalice at home, you can light it with me as I light the fellowship chalice, or my stand-in fellowship chalice. So we know where all our chalices are. Please write in the chat chalice lit in and the name of where you are at. Please say these words along with me as I light our chalice. And I'll go as slowly as I can so you can follow along. We light this chalice for the warmth of love, the light of truth, and the energy of action. And now I'll sing our bowl again, inviting you to draw a little deeper into the present moment, this our beloved community, and an invitation to play and have some fun.
This reading is from Julia Cameron, The Artist's Way. For most of us, the idea that the creator encourages creativity is a radical thought. We tend to think, or at least fear, that creative dreams are egotistical, something that God wouldn't approve of for us. After all, our creative artist is an inner youngster and prone to childish thinking. If our mom or dad expressed doubt or disapproval for our creative dreams, we may project the same attitude onto a parental God. This thinking must be undone. What we are talking about is an induced or invited spiritual experience. I refer to this process as spiritual chiropractic. We undertake certain spiritual exercises to achieve alignment with the creative energy of the universe. If you think of the universe as a vast electrical sea in which you are immersed and from which you are formed, opening to your creativity changes you from something bobbing in that sea to a more fully functioning, more conscious, more cooperative part of that ecosystem. As a teacher, I often sense the presence of something transcendent, a spiritual electricity, if you will, and I have come to rely on it in transcending my own limitations. I take the phrase inspired teacher to be quite literally a compliment. A higher hand than just my own engages us. Christ said, wherever two or more are gathered together, there I am in your midst. The God of creativity seems to feel the same way. The heart of creativity is an experience of the mystical union. The heart of the mystical union is an experience of creativity. Those who speak in spiritual terms routinely refer to God as the creator, but seldom see creator as the literal form for artist. I am suggesting that you take the term creator quite literally. You are seeking to forge a creative alliance, artist to artist, with the great creator. Accepting this concept can quite greatly expand your creative possibilities. And now join in, where appropriate, to the song, My Life Flows On in Endless Song.
Singing when time
And the crowd goes wild. Yeah. When the world around you feels dangerous, when every day seems to bring more uncertainty, what do you do to get through it? Within my cohort at seminary are numerous gamers, classmates and staff who engage in a wondrous variety of play. Anywhere from LARPing, which is live action role playing, to video games, to the more mundane board games and card games. When we get together together, we often make sure that we set aside an evening of just getting together and playing games. On more than one occasion, I listened to a couple of my classmates discuss Pokemon Go and the enjoyment they got from playing it. I remember one of my friends telling a group of us how it helped her to feel connected to her friends, both near and far. Now, I don't consider myself a gamer, at least in the technology area. And unfortunately, I have to admit, I was feeling a little judgmental about the whole idea of a game on a phone connecting people. Other than those little conversations, all I knew about Pokemon Go consisted of what I had heard on the radio when the game was first introduced. You might remember that, you know, people are looking down at their phone the whole time and walking off piers into lakes, things like that, because they weren't really paying attention. And then COVID happened. Now, I don't remember exactly how I started playing the game. You'd have to ask my daughter Tala about that. But I found myself playing it often. Tala and I would hang out. Let me put my little hat on here. Tala and I would go and hang out, and she taught me some of the basics of the game. I had to take Sonia out anyway. It was the only chance I usually had to get out because we were all self-quarantining. And I would find myself getting outdoors with her just a little bit more as I explored my common haunts with a new lens. Pokemon Go offered me a way to view my familiar surroundings with a fresh sense of possibility. It gave me a needed distraction during a time of worldwide chaos, confusion, and devastating loss. And it cracked my imagination open again. Now, in the artist's way, there are a couple basic to-dos that Julia Cameron requests. One, our morning pages, which is just general train of thought journaling. And the other one is making an artist date with yourself, a chance to go out and play and explore, do something different, something you might not have done before. And one of the nice things about this is that it's the concept of play that connects us with the sacred, that our imagination can make us wonder what else is possible other than what reality we might see around us. As I was looking through the interwebs, I was trying to find different gods of play. And I found many. And I'm not going to mention them all, but I'm going to name a few. And I apologize if I do mispronounce anything. Deities of play, Wope, a Lakota god of happiness and pleasure. Okshipili, In Aztec mythology, Oxapili was a god of love, games, beauty, dance, flowers, maize, and song. Ame no Uzume and Hotei are both Japanese deities called kami. Ame no Uzume is considered a deity of harmony, and Hotei is a deity of happiness, laughter, and the wisdom of contentment. In India, there is a goddess called Lalita, who is of represents happiness and playfulness. Re Aree is a Tahitian god of happiness and joy. And of course, in many of the indigenous cultures in North and South America are variations of the coyote trickster, who likes to shake things up a little bit and definitely play. We have a chance when we take ourselves out of our serious sides to notice things around us that are more divine. The other thing about play and pleasure is it is a way to end white supremacy culture. In her book, Pleasure Activism, Adrienne Marie Brown writes about pleasure as an important way to decolonize Black, Indigenous, and people of color's bodies. And she writes, pleasure activism is the work we do to reclaim our whole, happy, and satisfiable selves from the impacts, delusions, and limitations of oppression and or supremacy. Pleasure activism asserts that we all need and deserve pleasure, and our social structures must reflect this. In this moment, we must prioritize the pleasure of those most impacted by oppression. Pleasure activists seek to understand and learn from the politics and power dynamics inside of everything that makes us feel good. Pleasure activists believe that by tapping into the potential goodness in each of us, we can create justice and liberation, growing a healing abundance where we have been socialized to believe only scarcity exists. Ultimately, pleasure activism is us learning to make justice and liberation the most pleasurable experiences we can have on this planet. Adrienne Marie Brown discusses the impacts of colonization and ownership by others of Black and brown bodies, people like Henrietta Lacks, who had cells taken from her against her will and was not compensated. And these cells we see now regarding cancer. And so we're looking at these generational traumas of our BIPOC friends and family members and people that we love, and play and creating that space for them to have play is important in dismantling the oppression and white supremacy culture that we exist in right now. White supremacy culture has several characteristics: perfectionism, a sense of urgency, defensiveness, concept of quantity over quality, paternalism, individualism, power hoarding. There's more, but those just some to start with. As I go over those characteristics, concepts of play, self-care, spiritual connection, none of that is listed, not even remotely close. In the hard work of dismantling white supremacy culture, play should be deemed a sacrament. Play gives us a time to fill ourselves back up spiritually, emotionally. It gives us a chance to imagine what else is possible. When I looked at practices and tenets of self-care and spiritual practices and disciplines, some of the things that are included are things for cognitive and thinking, emotional well-being. Does it touch us in our social structures, in our behavior? Physical and spiritual connection. I see play in all of those. Thinking games, like maybe chess or checkers or different card games. Emotional, we'll do some of that maybe a little bit with some laughter. The chance to connect and be socially inclusive and play with our friends and neighbors and loved ones. Physical play, different things, hiking and observing in nature. Some people like weightlifting, some people like to dance. Lots of different physical things and spiritual, which can show up when we set that intention in any of the other four. Let's say that this play is sacred. It's sacred to me and it's sacred to the earth and to all of its inhabitants. So there are a lot of different ideas for play. Now, sometimes I like to still play with Legos. There's Pokemon. There are other things. And one of the beautiful things is there are so many different ways to play. And play might, one person's play might not be for somebody else. Somebody might like to play chess. Somebody else might like to run for 100 miles. And it's still considered play to them. And that is wonderful. It's wonderful to be in the both and. And it's wonderful to be able to try different and new things. Some of the other things that we have available is Interplay or Play Shop, which I'm going to put the shameless plug in for Lydia and her Play Shop workshops on, the first Saturday of the month. So it'll be one coming up this coming Saturday morning. And the concept of Interplay and Play Shop is that the body moves and creates sacred space in itself, in that movement and in that play. And it lets us put our guards down and our judgments aside. When we do the offering, we're going to ask a question and invite you to put other things in for ideas for play, stuff that comes from your youth. There is play in breath work. There can be play in meditation. One of the important parts of it is creating that time for yourself. Now, I want you to seriously create some time every week for play. Just don't take yourself or your play too seriously. But try to get away and do that. Play should be considered as essential as taking care of our loved ones, as essential as are the studies that we do and the energy that we put into the social action that we do. Now I'm going to put on my little hat here. Again. So, if you're on the younger side of the age spectrum, Remember to keep play as an important part of your life. Don't give it up. A few months ago, my daughter gave me one of the best compliments that I ever had. She said, "You know, Mom, you know what I really appreciate about you? And I'm thinking, "I don't know. What is it?" She says, "I love your childlike sense of wonder." And I had to think about that. My daughter feels like she doesn't have any. And when I looked back for a period in my life, I didn't have it either. And I worked playfully to get it back. And I appreciate it. And I was so grateful to hear that compliment. If you feel like play has been left behind somewhere through the years, don't be dismayed. I've mentioned a few ideas, and I imagine there might be some youth around you in your little Zoomiverses, or maybe listening in to our service, or you could probably check in with Jessica and some of the other School of the Spirit and Lifespan Education staff to get ideas of people you could talk to reintroduce you to the concept of play. To make it more sacred, ring a bell or light a candle and invite the deities of play to join you on your joyous journey. Thank you. Blessed be. And then we are going to share a children's song by Chick Corea. So enjoy.
Each week, we remind ourselves of the abundance of our lives and this community by giving one half of our plate away to those organizations that share our values. Today, we donate our half plate to CIRC, the Colorado Immigrants' Rights Coalition. Mercedes Garcia, an immigrant and former CIRC board member, and Josh Stallings of the North Regional Organizer for CIRC will be in a breakout room following the service for anyone who would like to learn more about CIRC's mission. And quite a mission it is. The fellowship has been a member of Colorado Immigrant Rights Coalition for over a decade. In that time, CIRC has grown to over 90 membership organizations, including organizations that also support women's rights, reproductive rights, workers' rights, LGBTQ rights, and more. CIRC has registered thousands of voters, increasing the number of Hispanic voters. CIRC has worked to become more immigrant-led. After many years of helping defeat anti-immigrant bills in the state legislature, CIRC, along with other organizations, brought about the passage of two pro-immigrant bills, including in-state tuition for undocumented students and driver's licenses for all. CIRC helped repeal Colorado's Show Me Your Papers law. CIRC will continue its active lead in repealing the many anti-immigrant laws that are still in effect, both at the state and the federal level, as well as advocating for those immigrant for the immigrant community in many other ways. Your generous support helps immigrant families improve both their living conditions and their safety. While you are making your contribution, we invite you to share in the chat what your favorite pastime was in your youth.
Thank you.
for the work of this fellowship, bringing love, reason, compassion, and justice to this world. And to the Colorado Immigrant Rights Coalition, we dedicate our offerings.
And now we sing.
From you I receive, to you I give, together we share, and from this we live.
And now I invite us into a time of community connection. Although reading all of those wonderful, fun pastimes from your youth, I'm feeling very connected right now, so thank you. But this is also a time of connection and sacred sharing. So if you'd like to share a joy or concern, there are some new instructions today. So please raise your hand by clicking the reactions button and then raising your hand. Or if you have an older version of Zoom, you may still find the raise hand button in the participants window. Tech Usher Deborah will unmute you, or you may see a pop-up window asking you to unmute yourself. If you prefer, you can share your joy or concern in the chat window by sending a chat to everyone, and then Deborah will read it out loud what you send. When you do share, whether by voice or by chat, please tell us your name and where you live, and briefly let us know what is in your heart today, and I'll put a stone in our sacred waters on your behalf. Beloveds, I look at all these faces and see smiles and frowns, maybe some distractions. I appreciate seeing all of you, or even seeing a box where somebody's name might be, knowing that you're there. I don't need my vision to know of your presence. I feel it in my soul and in my heart. I am grateful that you come here and share what is heavy and weighing on you. And I am also so grateful and blessed to see the things that you experience that bring you joy, and that you're willing to share those with others as ideas, as thoughts, as smiles. The things that bring us happiness can help us carry us through the things that bring us sadness and grief. May every day and in every dark corner and in every uncertain time, you have the opportunity to find joy and laughter to carry you through any troubled time that you might encounter. Blessed be. And now I'm going to invite you to sing Spirit Says Do along with Clara and Carmen. And I might just wiggle a little bit and dance.
Spirit says do, Spirit says do.
Oh yeah, that was amazing. Going to invite you to extinguish, it's a time to extinguish our chalices. We extinguish this chalice, but not the warmth of love, the light of truth, nor the energy of action. These we carry in our hearts until we meet again. And now for our benediction. I invite you to play a little game with me called Ha Ha. Now, this is a game from my youth, and I've never tried this on Zoom before. And I'm actually hoping that it might even be more silly and playful than when done in person. If you're willing and able, please unmute yourself. I'm going to start us off by saying ha, after which the other service leaders and tech ushers will add their ha's and ha-ha's. We'll keep going and invite you to join at any time and add your voice to the ha-ha chorus.
How does that happen?
And hopefully this will turn into some belly laughs, giggles, guffaws, etc.
We're messing up.
Ha.
Ha-ha.
Ha-ha. Thank you for trying this with me. May the laughter and playful spirit you found here nurture your imagination and connect you with the creative sacred. Blessed be.